Hello everybody. So probably by this time you are all familiar with what are digital circuits, why being a computer science student I should be studying something with respect to a digital circuit or a analog circuit. What do you mean by an equation? How do you represent a function? What do you mean by variables? What are the different forms in which a function can be represented? How it can be simplified? What are the different methods that are used for the simplification methods? What is an SOP form? What's a POS form? What's a truth table? What's a K-map? What do you mean by grouping in a K-map? What do you mean by quads? What do you mean by pairs? What do you mean by, or how exactly you are going to simplify them? Or how a bigger equation can be simplified to a very small form? So probably you are all familiar with this many things. And with an assumption that you are familiar with all these terms and all these technical concepts, we'll be moving on forward with a method which is called as Quinn-McCluskey method. So you people know how a function is represented. What do you mean by a variables? Or how a truth table should be written for a function? What do you mean by a two-variable function? What do you mean by a three-variable function? What do you mean by a four-variable function? And once a function has been written, it is always necessary for us to simplify a function. And why should we simplify a function? Once a function has been simplified, it always reduces the size of a circuit, very precisely a digital circuits. And to be very much precise, it reduces the number of gates and the wires and the inputs that are used in a digital circuits. Well, now, you people would be very much familiar with the method for simplification, which is called as K-map method, in which you used to write a truth table and used to number the columns of the K-map as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So you used to number the columns or houses of a K-map and used to fill the values in the columns of the K-map. Once the numbers are filled in the K-map, what you used to do was you used to pair them. I used to look for maximum number of ones in case of my SOP method, or if it was a POS method, I would be looking for maximum number of zeros. But most of the times I'll be going with the POS method, that is, I'll be looking for ones in my K-map. Once I find maximum number of ones, I'll be grouping them. I'll be grouping them as 8 ones, which is called as octet, or I'll be grouping them as 4 ones, which I call it as a quad, or I'll be grouping as 2 ones, which I'll be calling them as pairs. And in case if there are no ones available nearby or adjacently, I'll be keeping them as such. And after the grouping has been done, I'll be writing a simplified equation for that, and using some mathematical laws, I'll be simplifying the equations and I'll be getting a very simplified equation for a given function. The simplified equation, whatever I get using a K-map, will be implemented into a digital circuit, and this digital circuit will be written, and in case if you need it, you can implement it using the hardware kits, or you can implement it using the trainer kits, giving the needed inputs and obtaining the outputs. So here the method, which is called as QM method or Quinn-McCluskey method, is a method which we are going to use probably after the K-map method. Now the question what arises to me, or what arises to you people, is, sir, we already had a method which is called as K-map method, and we used to simplify a function and we used to get a simplified equation, and we used to implement that equation, and finally we used to get a digital circuit. Why this Quinn-McCluskey method? What are the advantages of Quinn-McCluskey method, or what are the disadvantages of K-map, which has been overcome in the Quinn-McCluskey method. The basic disadvantage of the K-map or Karnoff map method is that we can be using this method to simplify only a function which has got four variables. If the function has got more than four variables, we can simplify it using the K-map method, but the simplification process becomes much more complicated. It is very difficult to check out where are the pairs, where are the quads, where are the octets, or how exactly you need to simplify it. So in order to overcome that method, we have a method which is called as Quinn-McCluskey method. From the academic point of view, we'll be going only with the variable, or we'll be going only with the function which has got four variables, even in the Quinn-McCluskey method. But I can assure you that this method will be helping you people to simplify equation which has got more than four variables. This is basically a mathematical method which will take most of the time, or maybe it will be taking around 10 to 15 minutes of the time, but you people need to be a very careful observers if you need to get the right answer in this Quinn-McCluskey method. Just like how you people used to observe the ones in the K-map method before you pair them, or before you used to group them together, even in the Quinn-McCluskey method, you should be very keen observers if you need to get a very simplified equation. So let's check out how exactly this is done. What are the different methods, or what are the different steps that are involved in solving in this particular, or in this particular Quinn-McCluskey method? Fine. As I said, the advantages of the Quinn-McCluskey method. The Karnoff map method is an effective way to simplify switching functions which have a small number of variables. That is what I told you people. Here, small number refers to a function which has got four variables or less than four variables. When the number of variables is large, or if several functions must be simplified, the use of a digital computer is desirable. The Quinn-McCluskey method provides a systematic simplification procedure which can be readily programmed for a digital computer. As I said, I will be going on with this Quinn-McCluskey method in case if my circuit is pretty large, or if my circuit is complicated, or if there are more number of variables, I'll be going with the Quinn-McCluskey method, which gives me a simplified solution comparatively in an easier method when compared to the K-map method. The Quinn-McCluskey method reduces the mean term expansion, that is standard sum of product form of a function, to obtain a minimum sum of products. As I said you, most of the times for the academic purpose or from the individual levels, I'll be taking on a function which will be in the SOP method, and I would be expecting my output, or I would be expecting my final function to be in the SOP form itself. Fine. Let us check, or let's check out how exactly the Quinn-McCluskey method has to be, or how exactly we are going to go with this particular Quinn-McCluskey method. So what we'll be doing is, we'll be going directly with the numerical, because numerical will be giving me a very good understanding when compared to the theory part. If I go on explaining you the theory part, probably the theory part will be comparatively boring to you people, or you people may not be able to get the terms or get the technical terms. So what I did here is, I'll be directly getting into the method, taking a numerical. So what the question reads here is, find the SOP for a function which has got four variables. As I said earlier, from the academic point of view, or from the examination point of view, you people will be facing a question which will be having only four variables. Most of the times, they will not go beyond a function which has got more than four variables. They will just check whether you people know what is the Quinn-McCluskey method, and whether you people are familiar with the steps that you will be using in order to solve a numerical or solve a function to get a simplified function. So the problem reads, find the minimum SOP for a function which has got four variables, that is f of a, b, c, d equal to summation m 0, 1, 2, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 7, and 14. So this is what your numerical reads. So if you are a beginner, what you people should be able to do is, you should be able to write down a truth table. You people should be able to write down a truth table for a given function. So you should be able to write something like A, B, C, D and output, which will be the top columns. And first function will be 0, 0, 0, 0, which will be four zeros, and the output of that will be 1. That is why it is given as 0 here. That is why it is given as 0 here. Going on next, the next combination will be 0, 0, 0, 1. For that combination also, my output is going to be 1. So that is why you have 1 here. For the coming combination also, you have 0, 0, 1, 0. So that will also be equal to 1. Whereas the next combination, which is 3, has not been included here. So there, 0, 0, 1, 1, the output will be 0. That is why I don't have that 3 written here. So you people basically should be having a very sound knowledge about writing a truth table. That is what I told you in the beginning of this particular video. You people should be having a very sound knowledge regarding what is a function, how do you represent a function, how do you write a truth table, what is an SOP form, what is a POS form. So all those things should be familiar with you people. So what I did is I have written a truth table. It is not shown for you people here. From the truth table, I have picked up the numbers as it is shown here. See here, group 0. Group 0 is a group of the combination of the variables of a function which has got all four zeros. So that is 0, 0, 0, 0. If you go to the truth table, only one combination will be having all four zeros. So that is my group 1. It will be your group 0. Coming to group 1, group 1 is this combination of a variables which has got only one ones. Only one ones. So if you check out here from the truth table, it is 0, 0, 0, 1. It has got only one one. Coming to the next, 0, 0, 1, 0. So that has also got only one one. Coming to the next one, it is 1, 0, 0, 0. So all these numbers are included in your function. Only from the given function, I have taken that and I have written it. From the truth table, I have picked the numbers which has got 0 zeros, 1 ones, 2 ones, 3 ones and 4 ones. So the combination which has got all 4 zeros comes under one group, that is group 0. The combination of the numbers which has got 1 ones comes under one group. So that is 1, 2, 8. So that will be coming under group 1. Coming to the group 2, your group 2 will be containing a combination of the numbers which has got 2 ones. So 0, 0, 1, 0. This 5 is in the function. This 5 is in the function. Whereas you can say, so 0, 0, 1, 1 has also got 2 ones. But 0, 0, 1, 1 is 3, which is not given in the function from the truth table. From the truth table, it is not included. So that 3 is not here. So I have not included that. You can also say, sir, 0, 1, 0, 0 has also got 1 ones. Why didn't you write that? Because that 4 is not in the given function. So I'll be picking up only the numbers from the given function and I'll be grouping them as such. So here, my 5, 6, 9 and 10. This has got 2 ones. Those are grouped as one group. So three ones
are 7 and 14. The 7 and 14 from the truth table has got 3 ones. So I have grouped them into group 3. So this is how it has to be grouped. This is how I am going to begin with my Quinn-McCluskey method. My Quinn-McCluskey method will be beginning with this particular method, or this will be going on with this particular fashion. So you will be taking the function, you will be taking a question, you will be writing a truth table for that. I have not written a truth table here, assuming that you people are very familiar with writing the truth table. And once the truth table has been written, you will be picking up the numbers which has got no ones, one ones, two ones and three ones. In case if there are four ones, that is also fine with me. You can take that as a group here and you can write it down. So going on to the next slide. This is what my first group as it has been written here. Please concentrate very carefully. You need to be very keen observers here in order to get a right simplified function. However, we people will be going on with the actual numerical solving in the online classes. Whenever I go on with the online classes, I'll be taking an example and I'll be solving it live in front of you people. Okay. So here, your groups, whatever you had in the previous slide has been written here. That is your column 1, or you can name this as stage 1 also. This is your stage 1. Moving on to the next column, how are we going to write this particular next column? So please concentrate here. I'm just going to compare my first group, or I'm just going to compare my group 0 with group 1 with all the combinations. So I'm comparing 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Concentrate here. I'm comparing my first combination of first group with the first combination of the second group. So here you can check out 0 remains 0, 0 remains 0, 0 remains 0. Whereas coming to the next one, 0 has become 1. Whenever there is a change in a single variable, you just need to indicate it by a dash. Just check out here. 0 and 1 are compared. 0 and 1 are compared. It is written as 0, 1. And wherever there are no changes in the numbers, it is written as such. 0, 0. It is 0. 0, 0. It is 0. 0, 0. It is 0. Whereas the last number, 0, has changed to 1. Whenever there is a change in the variable, you will be indicating it by a dash mark. It can be a change from 0 to 1, or it can be changed from 1 to 0. Anything will do. So my 0 and 1 are compared. Let me compare my 0 and 2. Let me compare my 0 and 2 here. So once I compare 0 and 2 here, 0 remains 0, 0 remains 0, 0 has become 1. So how do I write it? I'll be writing it as 0, 2. 0 is remaining 0 itself, 0. So 0 is remaining 0 itself. I'll be writing it as 0 here. Next, my 0 has changed to 1. Whenever the change in the variable has occurred, I need to indicate it with a dash mark. So I've indicated it with a dash mark here. Coming to the next one, 0 has remained 0. So the comparison of 0 and 2 has given me 0, 0, dash, 0. I'll be comparing my 0 with 8. I'll be comparing my 0 with 8. This 0 has to be compared with everything. I'll be comparing it with 8. 0 will be compared with 8. So when I compare 0 with 8, I'll be writing it as 0, 8. So 0 has changed to 1. Once the number has changed from 0 to 1, I'll be writing it as dash. 0 remained 0. 0 remained 0. 0 remained 0. So what will be my combination be? My combination will be dash 0, 0, 0. Can you see that? Can you see that? You people came to know how exactly this has been obtained. I'm just comparing my first group with all the variables of the second group. All the variables of the second group. Similarly, I'll be comparing my first group with the second group. Once I go with the comparison of the first group with the third group, I can compare it only if there is change in one position. That is, only if a 0 has been changed to 1 in one position, then I can compare it. So here it has got all 4 zeros. Here I have got 2 ones and 2 zeros. So basically I cannot compare group 0 and group 2. The groups can be compared only if there is change in one position. If there is change in two numbers or two positions, you cannot compare that with the group. That is why I cannot compare 0 with the second group, neither I cannot compare 0 with the third group. Because in the second group, there are change in two positions. You can see here, if I compare, I need to write it as 0, 0. The 0 has changed to 1. So I need to write it as 0, dash, 0, dash, which is not allowed. So that is why I'll not go on comparing with the first group, with the second group, or I'll not be going on comparing with the groups which has got change in the position, or if there are changes in the variables in two positions. So I'll not go on with that. So what next? So thereby I finish off comparing the 0th group with the group 1. Next I'll be comparing group 1 with group 2. Group 1 with group 2 can be compared because there are 1 ones here and 2 ones here, which means there is change in one position. There is change in a variable by one position. So if I go on with that, you can see here, I'll be comparing with 1 and 5. I'll be comparing 1 and 5. Once I compare 1 and 5, I'll be writing it down here. You can check it here. Whenever there is a comparison going on, I need to write it down. I need to write it down like this. See here, you can check it. 1 and 5 are getting compared, I just wrote it as 2, 5. So when 1 and 5 are getting compared, it will become 0, 0, 0, 1. So this will become dash 0, 0, 1, 1. So you can check out here. When 1 and 5 are getting compared, it became 0, dash 0, 1. So 0 remained 0 itself. 0 became 1 here. That is why when I wrote the comparison, I showed it as dash 0 remained 0 here. So it is 0 itself. 1 remained 1 here. That is why it is written as 1 here. Clear with us? Fine. I'll be comparing this one with second combination of group 2. So this will be 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0. So how many position changes here? 0 remained 0. 0 became 1. So one position change. 0 became 1 here. So second position change. 1 became 0 here. So 3 position changes. I cannot write it down. I cannot compare 1 with 6. I'll be looking on with the change in the position in only one variable. So that is not possible. I'll go on with the comparing 1 with 9. If I go on with comparing 1 with 9, I'll check out. 0 remained, 0 became 1 here. So 1, 9, my first variable will be dash. Coming on next, 0 remained 0. 0 remained 0. 1 remained 1. So 1 and 9 can be compared. 1 and 9 can be compared. That is why I wrote it as 1, 9. I have written it as 1, 9 here. And I wrote it as dash 0, 0, 1. Hope you are getting all these particular points very clearly. So 1 will be compared with 10 again. If I compare 1 with 10 again here, not possible. If you check out here, 0 has changed to 1 here. 0 has remained 0 here. 0 has changed to 1. So 2 positional changes. No, I cannot write it. 1 has changed 0. So 1 and 10 cannot be compared. So what and all I can compare? I can compare 1 and 5. And I can compare 1 and 9 here. So only 2 combinations are possible in group 1 and group 2. Whereas there are remaining things left out. I need to compare this one. This has to be compared with the all 4 things. So I'll be comparing 2 with 5. 2 with 5 is not possible. 0 is remaining 0. 0 is becoming 1. 1 is becoming 0. 0 is becoming 1. 3 position changes. So 2, 5 is not possible. I'll compare 2 with 6. 2 with 6, let's check out. 0 is becoming remaining 0. 0 is becoming 1. 1 is becoming 1. 0 is remaining 0. Is remaining 0. So 1 positional changes. 2 and 6 can be compared. So if you can check out, 2 and 6 is written here with 0, dash, 1, 0. So whenever there is change in one position, I'll be indicating it with the dash. Similarly, I'll be comparing with 2 with 9. 2 with 9 is not possible. Probably there are change in two positions. I'll be comparing with 2 with 10. 2 with 10 is possible. That is why I wrote it as 2, 10. Similarly, I need to compare 8 with 5, 8 with 6, 8 with 9, and 8 with 10. So wherever there is change in one position, I can write it. I can see from my table here. I can see from my Quinn-McCluskey table here. 8 and 9 can be compared and 8 and 10 can be compared, which is having change in only one position. So that finishes my second task. Group 1 cannot be compared with group 3. As I said you, comparison is possible only if there is change in one position. If there is change in more than one position, no, I cannot compare. I cannot write it down in my column 2 or I cannot write it down in my stage 2. So this group 1 cannot be compared with group 3. What is left out next? Next, what is left out is I need to compare the elements of the group 2 with group 3, because group 2 has got 2 ones, group 3 has got 3 ones. So the changes are with respect to one position. So what I do here is I'll be comparing it 5 with 7. Once I compare 5 with 7, I'll be getting it as 0, 1, dash 1. So it will be 0 is remaining 0 here, 1 is remaining 1 here, 0 is changing to 1. When 0 is changing to 1, I'll be indicating it with the dash mark. Similarly, 1 is remaining 1 here. So it will become 0, 1, dash 1. Clear with this? Yes. Moving on further, I need to compare with 5 with 14. 5 with 14 is not possible because there are change in two positions. I'll be going on with comparing 6 with 7. 6 with 7, that is possible because there will be change in only one position, which indicates me or which gives me an output of 0, 1, 1, dash. I'll be comparing with 6 with 14. 6 with 14 is possible. So I have written it as 6, 14 with the respective changes. I'll be comparing 9 with 7, not possible. 9 with 14, not possible. 10 with 7, not possible. 10 with 14, it is possible. That is why I have written it as 10, 14 as 1-10. This finishes my column 2. This finishes my column 2. Moving on further, column 3, or I can call it as stage 3. You can call it as column or you can call it as stage, no issues. But the stages or columns depends on the number of variables. For example, if my function has got 4 variables, I will normally be ending up with 3 stages or 3 columns. If there are n variables, I normally need to note down n minus 1 stages or n minus 1 columns. Okay, now again my comparison should go on. Now as of now, for me this is group 1. For me this is group 1. This entire thing is group 2 and this entire thing is group 3. So I need to compare my group 1 with group 2 here. So what I'll do is I'll go on checking. I'll check whether 0-1 can be compared with 1-5. I'll check it. So 0-1 can it go on? 0 is remaining 0. 0 it is dash here, which is not possible. I should be having a number here. If I need to compare, I should be having a number here. And the 0 is remaining 0. Again, this dash is becoming 1. This dash is becoming 1. So that is not possible. I'll be comparing this 0-1 with 1-9. So 0 has become dash. 0 has become dash here. This 0 is 0 itself. 0 is 0 itself. Dash has become 1. Dash and 0 or dash and 1 cannot be compared. That is why 0-1, 1, 9 cannot be compared. Same problems with 0-1 and 2-6. 0-1 and 2-10. 0-1 and 8-9. Once I go with 0-1, 8-9, check it very carefully. 0-1. 0 is becoming 1 here. 0 is remaining 0 here. 0 is remaining 0 here. Dash is remaining dash here. As I said you earlier, there should be change only in one position or one variable. You can check out. See, dash is remaining dash itself. 0 is remaining 0 itself. 0 is remaining 0 itself. But the 0 is becoming 1. So I can write it as 0-1-8-9. 0-1-8-9. Once I compare, I'll be getting the output as -0-0-. Clear with this? Similarly, I need to compare my second combination or second variable of group 1 with all the elements of the group 2. With all the elements of group 2. Once I compare this, I'll be finding that 0-2 can be compared only with 8 and 10. See here, 0 has become 1 here. So that will become dash. 0 has remained 0 itself. Dash has remained dash itself. 0 has remained 0 itself. So it will become -0-0. You can check out here. -0-0. Similarly, I can compare 0-8 with remaining things. I can compare it with 0-8. It is possible to compare with 1-9. They have striked it off. I'll tell you why they have striked it off or why that particular combination has been striked up later. So 0-8 I can compare. Check out here. 0-8 and 1-9 can be compared. Dash is dash itself. 0 is 0. 0 is 0. 0 has become 1. So I can write 0-8-1, 9. 0-8-1, 9. -0-0-0. Similarly, 0-8 can be compared with 2, 10. Once I go on with this comparison, I'll be getting it as -0-. So I can be writing only so much combinations or so much comparisons with respect to first group and the second group. Next, I'll be going on with the comparison of the second group with the third group. Once I go on with the comparison of the second group and the third group, I'll be getting combinations or comparisons happening only between 2, 6, 10 and 14. 2, 6, 10 and 14. These are the only comparisons that is possible. So I'll be writing this. Check out here. 2, 6, 10 and 14. So 0 has become 1. That is dash. Dash is remaining dash itself. 1 is remaining 1 here. 0 is remaining 1. Which means there is only change by one position. So this becomes -0-1-0. -0-1-0. Again, I can compare 2, 10 with 6, 14. But this 2, 10, this combination when it is compared with 10, 14, it basically means the same. If you check out here, it has just jumbled up. 2, 6, 10, 14, 2, 10, 6, 14. I can actually write it as 2, 6, 10, 14, which basically gives me the same combination. If you want, as of now, don't strike off any numbers. Let's keep all this unstrike numbers as such. Let us not strike any of the numbers. Striking has happened because of some other reason, which I'll let you know probably in the very coming next slide. So this is how the comparison has to be done. This is from the truth table for the given combinations. For the given combinations, I'll be comparing and I'll be writing a group which has got all four zeros, one ones as one group, two ones as one group, and three ones as one particular group. Once this has been done, I'll be going on the comparison. And comparison can happen only if there is change in one position. If there is change in one position, the change position will be indicated by a dash. The remaining numbers will be written as such. That finishes off my second stage. Again, in the second stage, you will go on with the comparison between the groups. Again, there you need to go on with the comparison only if there is change in one position. And once the comparison has been done, you will be landing up with the stage 3. As my question has got only 4 variables, I can go only with 3 stages, or I can be going only with 3 columns. I cannot go on further. I cannot compare the things further. See here, what are the tick marks basically put up for? What are the tick marks basically put up for? The tick marks are basically put up to say that this has been compared and the compared output has been written. This has been compared. See here, 0 and 1 has been compared. Yes, 0 and 1 has been compared. So put a tick mark. 0 and 2 has been compared. Yes, put a tick mark. See here, I have written the result. 0 and 8 has been compared. Yes, 0 and 8 has been compared and I got some result here. Similarly, 1 and 5 has been compared. Yes, 1 and 5 has been compared. 1 and 9 has been compared. 2 and 6 has been compared. 2 and 10 has been compared. 8 and 9 has been compared. 8 and 10 has been compared. So whichever has undergone the comparison, you just put a tick mark here. You just put a tick mark here. Coming on to this stage, you check out here. 0, 1 has been compared with 8, 9. So, I'll obviously put a tick mark here. I'll obviously put a tick mark here. And 0, 2 has undergone a comparison with 8, 10. So, I'll put a tick mark here and I'll put a tick mark here. Similarly, 0, 8 has undergone a comparison with 1 and 9. So, I'll put a tick mark here and I'll put a tick mark here. Similarly, 0, 8 has undergone a comparison with 2, 10. So, I'll put a tick mark. You don't have to put double tick marks here. You just have to put a single tick mark saying that the compared result has been written. So 08, 210 has been written. Similarly, 26 has undergone a comparison with 10, 14. Similarly, 210 has undergone a comparison with 10, 14. But check out here, there are some columns or there are some variables which is where there is no tick mark. Because 15 has not undergone a comparison here. Can you see any number 15, 1, 5 anywhere? Nowhere I can see them. So this has not been put a tick mark, which says that it is not compared. 5, 7. Can you see any combinations of 5, 7 here? No, they have not undergone comparison. So 5, 7, there is no tick mark. Can you see anywhere 6 and 7 in together? 6 and 7 together has not undergone a comparison, because of which this 3 terms do not have any tick mark existing there. Clear with this? Okay. Now, what we need to do is, the column, whatever I found out here, or the third column, or the very final comparison, what I have here, this is called as prime implicants. Prime implicants means something like this. See, here I can see 0, 1, 8, 9, 0, 2, 8, 10, 0, 8, 1, 9, 0, 8, 2, 10, 2, 6, 10, 14, 2, 10, 6, 14. All the very final columns has been reproduced here. It has been reproduced here. It is written as 0, 1, 8, 9. If you go back, yes, it is 0189. And here dash 00. So what are the variables I'm going to write? Those variables are B dash C. So whichever it is 00, it is B dash C. So 00, this is A, B, C, and D. So if it is dash 00 dash, so 0 represents inverted value. So this, if it is 0 here, it says it is B dash. This is C dash. If I come here, this is B dash. This is D dash. If I take here, this is B dash, C dash. If I take here, this is B dash, D dash. If I take here, This is dash dash. This is 1. 1 is in the place of C. So that is A, B, C and D. So it is 1 here. This will be CD. This will also be CD. Now the question comes, why did you strike off this particular thing, sir? Why did you strike off this particular things? If you compare 0189 and if you compare 0819, they are the jumbled forms. That's it. They are the jumbled forms, which means I can write this as 0189. So as they are repeating again, 0189, 0819, I can write this as 0189. So as they are appearing two times, I just striked it off because the variable whatever I am going to get in my final function will be, this is B dash C dash, this is also B dash C dash. When you are writing a circuit, why will you have a circuit which has got two inputs two times? Similarly, if you check out this 0 to 8 10 and 0 8 2 10, so this will be written as 0 to 8 10 itself. So this is actually B dash D dash, this is also B dash D dash, which is same input. So I don't have to write the variables which are having the same things again and again. That is why I just striked off this and I have just striked off this here. Coming to this again, 2 6 10 14 is actually giving me an output of C D dash. This again gives me an output of C D dash. So you can either strike this off or you can either strike this off. So anything is possible. That is why it has been striken off. But when I write the prime implicant table, this is how it is actually done. See, I have written all the things 0189, 0218, 2610, 14, 15, 57. Now check out this. There is an important interesting thing that's happening here. 0189, 0819. So I am not going to write it again in my prime implicant table. 0210, 0810. I am not going to write this particular numbers again. So 0189 is written once. 0 to 810 is written once. 2 6 10 14 is written once. 2 6 10 14 is written once. All these three values actually has come from the third column. This has actually come from the third column. You can check out here. 0189 B dash C dash. Why B dash C dash? B dash C dash. 0 to 810. It is actually B dash D dash. It is actually B dash D dash. And this one 2 6 10 14 is actually, what will be this? This will be C and D dash. You can check out here, it is C and D dash. Sir, from where did I get all this particular thing, sir? This is what I was saying you. You are going to put a tick mark to the numbers that are getting compared. If you are not put a tick mark to the numbers that have been compared, you will not be having them sorted out. So this 1, 5, 5, 7, 6, 7 are not compared at all in the second stage, which are also a prime implicant. If you check out here, 1, 5, 5, 7, 6, 7. So 1, 5 is actually 0. 0 is A dash. This is already A dash, no issues. This is C dash. This is D. So this will be A dash, C dash, D. If you can check out here, it is A dash, C dash, D. Next 5, 7. 5, 7 is not compared. So this will be A, B and D. If you check out here, A dash, B and D. See here, A dash, B and D. 6, 7, A dash, B and C. See here, A dash, B and C. This is how this table is prepared. Moving on here, I'll be writing down the numbers as such that is given in the question. 0, 1, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 14. These are the same things given. That is 0, 1, 5, 6, 7, 1, 0, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 14. All these numbers I'll be writing down as such here. Okay. 0, 1, 8 and 9. This is from here. 0, 1, 8 and 9. So here. So put a tick mark under this respective numbers. Under 0, put a tick mark. Under 1, put a tick mark. Under 8, put a tick mark. Under 9, put a tick mark. So B dash C dash corresponds to 0189. After comparing 0189, you are going to get a resultant B dash C dash. Next one, that is B dash D dash. 0 to 810. 0 to 8 and 10. Put a tick mark under the respective numbers. This is 2, 6, 10, 14 corresponding to CD dash. This is 2, 6, 10 and 14. Don't worry about the circles here. Don't worry about the circles here. I'll just explain what are those circles. Coming here, 1 and 5. A dash, C dash, D corresponds to 1 and 5. 5, 7. That is corresponding to A dash, B, D. These are all from my table. These are all from my table. I didn't do any black magic in order to get these numbers here. I've just picked the things what are not compared either in the final stage or in the second stage. Or if any of the things are not getting compared in the primary stage, I need to take them and I need to write it down here. But here all the numbers are getting compared. That is why I have not taken down and I have not written. Here there are three things which are not compared. And here there are three things which are not compared because of which I have got six combinations here. So 1, 5, 5, 7 and 6, 7. This is my prime implicants. So you can write your function as, f is equal to b dash c dash plus b dash d dash plus cd dash plus a dash c dash d plus a dash bd plus a dash bc. So now my function will be looking comparatively large. But what was your intention behind? Your intention was you wanted to make the function or you wanted to make the equation look as small as possible. That's what you are trying to do in the Quinn-McCluskey method. So this is your prime implicants. Now what we need to do is, we need to pick up the essential prime implicants from this and write down the equation. How are we going to do that? Okay, here. See, the same table. Nothing else has been done. The same table. I'm having the same table here. See, it's the same X marks, whatever you have put up here. Now check out. Okay. 0, 1, 8, 9. The 0, concentrate here, the 0 is appearing even in the next function. The 0 is appearing even in the next function. So what you can do is, you can write down, please concentrate, you can write down, this is 0, 1, 8 and 9. 0, 1, 8 and 9, which is a prime implicant, which is a prime implicant. You can write down this function as such. See here, f is equal to b dash c dash. So first function has been written as such. Coming to next one, which is b dash d dash. When you come to b dash d dash, please concentrate. The 0, which is a part of b dash d dash, has already occurred in the first variable. This has already occurred in the first variable. This d dash has not occurred anywhere. Has not occurred anywhere. This 8 or this 8 has already occurred in the primary or it has already occurred in the first function. And thus, last one, that is 10. 0, 2, 8, 10. This has not occurred anywhere. So, what I do is, I'll be writing the first function as such. A part of the second function, that is my first thing, is appearing in the first function. So, I'll not write down that B dash C dash or I'll not be writing down that B dash D dash. I'll check whether it will be occurring in the coming functions. So, I'll be going on with the next one. C D dash. So if you, when you write CD dash, which is 2, 6, 10, 14, this is already occurred in the first function. My second variable is occurring in the third function. It is occurring in the third function. Third one is already occurred in the first function. The fourth one is occurring in the third function, which means that I need not write down this. I need not write down this B dash D dash because the part of that, that is B dash D dash, is half of that is occurring in the first function and half of that is occurring in the third function. So this is not to be written. This is just like you are applying some associative or distributive or some of the theorems and you are simplifying it. But instead of going with the theorems or something, I'm just going on with the graphical method. So my first function b dash c dash is written as such. b dash c dash is written as such. B dash d dash is not written because the numbers corresponding to b dash d dash are already occurring in the first function and the second function. So b dash d dash is not to be written. Coming to the c dash or cd dash, when you come to cd dash, you can check out here. This is occurring in the second function, but my second function is not written. My second function is not written and this is not occurring anywhere else because of which cd dash has to be written. because of this occurring only in the second function, but that is not occurring in any other things. You would have omitted this particular CD dash if you had written B dash D dash. But B dash D dash has not been written. That is why I will be writing CD dash as such. See, this is occurring in the part of the second one, but second one is not written here. Third thing, that is 6, is occurring as a part of the last one. So that is okay. This is occurring as a part of the previous function. So that is not written. This is not occurring anywhere, which means that this one and this one are not occurring anywhere, which is part of the second function, which is not occurring anywhere, because of which you have to write CD dash as such. B dash D dash need not be written because part of which is occurring in the first function and part of which is occurring in the third function. But third function, a part of it is occurring in other functions, but there are some parts which are not occurring at all. So C dash D dash is written. Coming to the next one, 1 5 1 5, here you can check out here, A dash A dash C dash B dash. This is occurring in the one of the function, that is primary function, and this is occurring in the second function. Either you can write A dash C dash D, or you can write it as A dash B D. So here you can check out A dash C dash D. This is occurring here, and this is occurring in this one. That is why I have omitted of this A dash C dash D. A dash B dash D. You can check out, this is occurring here, but this function has not been written, and this is occurring here. So because of this particular sequence, I need to write A dash B dash D in the final function. Coming to the last one, 6 and 7, you can check out 6 and 7. See, 6 and 7, this 6 is occurring as a part of the third function, and this is occurring as a part of the previous one. This is already been written, so I need not be writing this, because of which my prime implicants were 1 2 3 4 5 6, out of which I picked up only the essential ones, and these are my essential prime implicants, and these are my essential prime implicants. This is why I said you need to be very keen observers. If you miss out even a single term, probably your output may not change, or your output may not change. But imagine you are writing an equation which contains all the 6 terms. Your equation will be looking comparatively bigger. Now look into the beauty of this. The equation which had 6 terms has been freezed down to an equation which contains only 3 terms. So you need to be observing this particular thing very carefully, and if you have to arrive at this, this has to be done very carefully. This comparison has to be done very carefully. If this comparison goes wrong somewhere, this table is missed out. And if this table is missed out, this is once again going to be missed out. So that is why I said, you people need to be very keen observers. If you are not a keen observer, or if you cannot concentrate on this particular numerical, probably on the question paper you are going to lose somewhere around 8 or 12 marks. If the expression is comparatively bigger, it will be coming out for 12 marks, and if the expression is comparatively smaller, they might ask you for 8 marks. But your observation is of utmost importance in this particular method. Whereas in the K-map method, maybe even if you didn't observe, if you are good at associative or some other laws, you could have sorted it out. But here, even though you know the associative laws, they will just look into this particular table. They will just look into this particular mapping. And based on this mapping, you will be getting this particular expression. If you are not able to get this particular expression, your entire circuit is gone, because you are not going to get the output whatever you are expecting. So this is what is Quinn-McCluskey method. Let's go with one more. Let's have a very brief discussion regarding this. Determine the essential prime implicants using the Quinn-McCluskey method for the function f of ABCD equal to summation m 0, 1, 2, 3, 10, 12, 11, 13, 14, and 15. Actually, it should have been 12 and 11 and 12 here. No issues. That is not going to make any difference for me. And you got to make sure that this summation m says that it is a SOP form, and phi m says that it is a POS form. So be very careful. So I have just written the things here. See, I told you, I can name it as columns, or I can name it as stages. It's up to you people on what method you are comfortable with. So how many variables here? I got 4 variables. Once you have 4 variables, as I said, there should be 3 stages or 3 columns. So stage 1, stage 2, and stage 3. Okay. What is my first work? My first work is take or group them into 0 ones, 1 ones, 2 ones, 3 ones and 4 ones. They are available. 0 ones, 1 group, 1 ones, 1 group, 2 ones, 1 group, 3 ones, 1 group, 4 ones, 1 group. What is your next job? You just need to go on comparing. So I can compare my first group with the second group. So this becomes 0 will be compared with 1. Once I compare with 0 my with 1, I'll write it as 0, 1. So it will be 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 has become 1 here. So I can write it as 0, 0, 0, dash, 0, 0, 0, dash. Again, I'll compare with 0 with 2 because there is change in one position. So 0, 0, 0, 0, this will become dash and this is 0, 0. So comparison of the first group and the second group is done. Now go on with the comparison of the second group and the third group. Because there is 1 once here and there are 2 once here. As I said, you comparison can be done only between the groups where there is change in one variable position. Okay. So 1 and 3 can be compared because it will become 0, 0, 0, 0. This will become dash. This will become 1. So 0, 0, dash, 1. 1 and 10 cannot be compared because I have got 1 once here and I have got 2 once here. Cannot be compared. 1 can be compared with the 12, not possible because I got 1 once here and I got 2 once here. So I'll go on with comparison of 2 and 10. 2 and 10. The comparison of 2 and 10 has been done. Again, the third group and fourth group has to be compared. Once I go with the comparison of the third group and fourth group, these are the things what I'll be obtaining. Whenever there is a change in a variable, you just indicate with the dash mark. And if the variable remains the same, you just indicate it as such. For example, if I go with my 3 and 11, it will become 0 and 1. 0 has changed to 1. So this will become dash. 0 has remained 0. So it will be 0. 1 and 1 will be 1. 1 and 1 will be 1. So it will become dash 0, 1, 1. So here it is. Dash 0, 1, 1. So go on comparing. Everything has to be compared. Don't give any chances. You just observe very neatly and observe very carefully and compare the variable combinations here. So this finishes my second group. First group with the second group, second group with the third group with the fourth group and fourth group with the fifth group. Once I finish off my comparisons of the stage 1, I will be obtaining something called as stage 2. Start your comparisons in the stage 2. So here I will be comparing this, which is known to be a group 1 with a group 2. So I will be writing it as 0, let me check out whether I can compare. I can compare 0. Here. Can I compare 0, 1, 1 and 3? Not possible because 0 is 0 here, 0 is 0 here, 0 has changed to dash. A number 0 cannot be changed to dash. Now 0 can be changed either to 1 or 1 can be changed to 0. 0 cannot be changed to dash or dash cannot be changed to 1 or 1 cannot be changed to dash. So that is not possible. I will be taking 0, 1 with 2, 3. So 0, 1, 2, 3 I can check out. 0 is changed to 0. 0 is remaining 0. 0 is remaining 0, 0 has changed to 1 and dash is remaining dash. So I can compare 0, 1, 2, 3. See here, 0, 1, 2, 3. That's why I put a tick mark. 0, 1 and 2, 3 are getting compared. 0, 2 and can I compare it? 0, 2 and 1, 3. Yeah, I can compare 0, 2 and 1, 3. So basically, you can check out here. I can strike off any one of this. I can strike off any one of this. Because 0, 1, 2, 3 and 0, 2, 1, 3 are basically the same things. So this is the resultant what I obtained by comparing second and third group. Once I went on with the comparison of the second and third group, I obtained something dash 0, 1, dash. That is by comparing 2, 10, 3 and 11. Similarly, third and fourth group, if I go on comparing, I get something here. And you can check out here, everywhere there is a tick mark. Everywhere there is a tick mark which says that all the combinations of the second group or second stage has been compared. There is nothing there that has not undergone comparison. It has undergone comparison and it has been compared and the result has been written. See here. So here I will be writing it as 0, 0. 0, 0 stands for A dash, B dash. One prime implicant. Second prime implicant is B dash, C. Third prime implicant is AC. This is also AC. So you need not write it down again. So So I will be writing this only once. I'll be writing this only once, and I'll be writing this also only once, and this also I'll be writing it only once, because you can check out 0, 1, 2, 3 and 0, 2, 1, 3 means the same. Here 11, 14, 15 and 10, 14, 11, 15 means the same. 12, 13, 14, 15 and 12, 14, 13, 15 means the same. So basically there are only 3 prime implicants coming on here. See here. It's taken 0, 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 10, 11. Sorry. Yeah, here. Yeah, 0, 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 10, 2, 10, 3, 11, 10, 11, 14, 15, 10, 11, 14, 15, and 12, 13, 14, 15. So basically there are around 1, 2, 3, and 4, 4 prime implicants, 4 prime implicants. So thus A dash B dash is obtained because of comparing 0, 1, 2 and 3. So I'll be putting tick marks under 0, 1, 2 and 3. B dash C dash, that is this one. B dash C dash or B dash C, sorry. B dash C is obtained by comparing 2, 10, 3 and 11. So I'll be putting a tick mark 2, 3, 10 and 11. Next one. This is obtained by comparing 10, 11, 14, 15. So this is A and C. A and C. Similarly, this is obtained by A and B. 12, 13, 14, 15. So 12, 13, 14, 15. So wherever, whichever numbers I do have here, I'll be putting a tick mark. So when you are writing, these are my prime implicants. I need to pick up the essential ones from here. I need to write the essential ones here. So I'll be writing F is equal to A dash B dash. Normally, first function I'll be writing down as such, because previously there will be no comparison happening, right? So this thing I'll be writing it as such. When I come to this, when I come to B dash C, please concentrate. Two of the tick marks are already present from the previous ones. And the next two tick marks actually come from the next ones. So what you can do is, you can skip off this B dash C. You can skip off this B dash C as it has been done here, as it has been done here. And you can write it as A dash B dash plus AC. Because in AC, you have two tick marks here, which is already from the previous one, and two tick marks from here, which is actually the new ones. So it will be AC can be written as such. And coming to AB, these are two new tick marks which has not occurred anywhere. So you can either write it as A dash B dash plus AC plus AB, or you can write it as A dash B dash plus B dash C plus AB. Sir, why did you skip off AC? If you check out AC here, part of AC is occurring in B dash C and part of AC is occurring in AB. So you need to observe very carefully whether this has been covered in the previous function or whether this has been covered in the next function. If the entire thing has been covered up either in the previous or in the next function, you can skip off that. That is what is Quinn-McCluskey method. So here, how you would have written it previously was, you would have written it as A dash B dash plus B dash C plus AC plus AB. But right now, you can write it as A dash B dash plus BC plus AB. Just got only three combinations. Or A dash B dash plus AB plus AB. This is how it goes on.